Hello students, hope you all are fine and safe at your home. In the previous class, we discussed about how to convert the equation of straight lines in different forms. So what we discussed there in that one, if a straight line is there in this form, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, then how we can convert it into, first one we studied how we can convert it into slope intercept form there. Slope intercept form. So for that what we did, except y, rest all the numbers we shifted to right hand side. Then we got the equation in this way. Y is equal to minus ax by b minus c by b. So as we know, general form of slope intercept form is y is equal to mx plus c, where m, coefficient of x, gives the slope of the line and c is the y-intercept, where the line intersects the y-axis. So here, if we will rewrite in this way, y is equal to minus ax by b minus c by b, then minus a by b means coefficient of x will be the slope of the line and minus c by b will be the y-intercept. And then what we studied? We studied how to convert it into intercept form. Intercept form. Standard equation is x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. So first what we did, we converted the given equation of line in standard form. So for that we did here ax plus by is equal to minus c. And then since in the standard form right hand side is equal to 1, so divided the whole equation by minus c. Then we will get here ax by minus c plus by minus c is equal to 1. But in the standard form, coefficient of x and y both is equal to 1. So here also coefficient of x and y should be equal to 1. So to make it equal to 1, what we did there, we shifted this a to the denominator. So we wrote in this way, x divided by minus c by a plus y divided by minus c by b is equal to 1. So whatever number you are getting below x, that is the x-intercept. And whatever number you are getting below y, that is the y-intercept. X-intercept means the line intersects the x-axis at that point. Y-intercept means the line intersects the y-axis at that point. And then we have checked how to convert into normal form. So I think that form is easy for you. We discussed so many questions also. Now today we can check how to solve some question based on this application. Okay, so the first question is written, find the equation of line which is parallel to 3x minus 2y plus 5 is equal to 0 and passes through the point minus 5 comma 6. What we have to do? We have to find the equation of a line which is parallel to this line. So here we have to find the equation of a line which passes through the point 5 comma 6 and parallel to the line 3x minus 2y plus 5 is equal to 0. So these two lines are parallel to each other. We have to find the equation of this line. So suppose this line I am taking as L there, and this one you can take as L1. So now here the condition is given, L is parallel to L1. We have to find the equation of L. So as we know, to find the equation of L, what are the things we need? Yes, we need the slope of the line and we need a point on the line. So a point on the line is given. Now what we need? We need the slope of the line. To calculate the slope of the line, this information is given. The given line L is parallel to L1. So can we calculate what will be the slope of the line L1? How we will calculate? Yes, by converting this equation into slope intercept form. Slope intercept form means except y, rest all the things we will shift to right hand side, or 2y we can shift to right hand side because that is negative. Then what will come? 2y is equal to 3x plus 5. Again, coefficient of y should be equal to 1. Except y, no other numbers should be there in left hand side. So just shift 2 to right hand side, then it will be equal to y is equal to 3 by 2 x plus 5 by 2. So we know, now we converted it in the form y is equal to mx plus c. M denotes the slope of the line. Mx means what is the coefficient of x, that will be the slope of the line. So here, what is the coefficient of x we are getting? 3 by 2. So just write down there, slope of L1 is equal to 3 by 2. Slope of L1 is equal to 3 by 2. And now we will write down there L. The line L is parallel to L1. Then what will be the slope of the line L? Slope of the line L. Suppose I am taking the slope as M. What will be the slope? If the two lines are parallel to each other, yes, their slopes will be equal. So slope of the line L also will be equal to 3 by 2. Now we got the slope of the line and the point is already given. Now we will write down equation of L is equal to y minus y1. In place of y1, what we have? 6 is equal to m, that is equal to 3 by 2 into x minus minus 5. So we will get x plus 5. Now what we can do? We can shift this 2 to left hand side. Then we will get 2y minus 12 is equal to 3x plus 15. Now we can shift all the expression to right hand side. Then what will become? 3x plus 2y will become minus 2y plus 15 plus 12. So that will be equal to plus 27 is equal to 0. So in this way we got the equation of line L, which is parallel to this line and passing through the point minus 5 comma 6. Okay, now in the next question, now we can check what does the next question says. Now in the next question it is written, find the equation of straight line that passes through the point 3 comma 4. We have to find the equation of a line that passes through the point 3 comma 4 and perpendicular to the line, and it is perpendicular to the line 3x plus 2y plus 5 is equal to 0. So this line, suppose we can take it as L1 with the slope M1, and we have to find the equation of this line L, and the slope we can take as M there. Okay, so again we have to find the equation of L there. To get the equation of L, we need a point on the line L and we need the slope there. So point already given in the question, 3 comma 4, but slope is not given. To calculate the slope, what is given? Yes, L is perpendicular to L1. So first what we can do, we can calculate what will be the slope of L1. How we will do it? Yes, by converting it in the form of y is equal to mx plus c, or slope intercept form. So except that y, rest all the numbers we will shift to right hand side. Then how it will come? 2y is equal to minus 3x minus 5. Now we can divide the whole equation by 2. Then we will get y is equal to minus 3 by 2x minus 5 by 2. So now from here, can you tell me what is the slope of L1 that we have taken as M1? So here we can write M1 is equal to minus 3 by 2. But we have to find the slope of L. Now check the relation which is given. L is perpendicular to L1. So if it is perpendicular, what will be the relation in their slopes? Product of the slopes is equal to minus 1. So how we will get the slope of the line L? Yes, take the reciprocal and change the sign. So you can write down there. Therefore, M is equal to, take the reciprocal, 2 by 3 and change the sign. So minus will become plus there. So we got the slope of the line L. Now write down there equation of L. So according to the formula, y minus y1, in place of y1 we have 4, is equal to m, 2 by 3 into x minus x1. Again 3 we can shift to left hand side. Then we will get 3y minus 12 is equal to 2x minus 6. Now we can shift all to one side. Then what will come? 2x minus 3y minus 6 plus 12. So that will be equal to plus 6 is equal to 0. So I think how to use the concept is clear. Okay. Now next question. In question number 3, it is written, find the equation of a line perpendicular to x minus 2y plus 7 is equal to 0. We have to find the equation of a line which is perpendicular to x minus 2y plus 7 is equal to 0 and having y intercept minus 2. So it is given y intercept is equal to minus 2. What is the meaning of that one? Y intercept minus 2. So when you will draw the diagram correctly, it will come in this way. We have to find the equation of a line which is perpendicular to this line and having y intercept minus 2 means it is intersecting the y axis at the point minus 2. So minus 2 will be here only. So if you will write the coordinate of this point, what will come? It is on y-axis, so it will be equal to 0, comma minus 2. So here you can write down, it passes through the point 0, comma minus 2 and is perpendicular to the line x minus 2y plus 7 is equal to 0. Now we can simplify it. So for that, first what we need? We need the slope of the line. So again, this one we can take as L1 with slope M1 and this is the line L with slope M. So first we can convert it into slope intercept form. So 2y we can shift to right hand side. Then we will get 2y is equal to x plus 7. So divide the whole equation by 2. Then we will get y is equal to 1 by 2x plus 7 by 2. So what is the slope? Yes, m is equal to, m1 is equal to 1 by 2. Now write down there, since it is given, L is perpendicular to L1, therefore, what will be the slope of L? Take the reciprocal and change the sign. So, it will be equal to minus 2. Now, we will write down equation of L. According to the formula, y minus y1. In place of y1, we have minus 2. Then, we will get y plus 2 is equal to m minus 2 into x minus x1, so x minus 0. Just to simplify it, then we will get y plus 2 is equal to minus 2x plus 0, or 2x also we can shift here. Then we will get 2x plus y plus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, now check the next question. In question number 4, it is written, find the angle between the lines y is equal to 2 minus root 3 into x plus 5. First equation is this one. And second equation is y is equal to 2 plus root 3 into x minus 7. So we have to find the angle between these two lines. What is the formula to calculate the angle between the two lines? Yes, do you remember the formula? Yes, that is tan theta is equal to, the formula is tan theta is equal to modulus of m1 minus m2 by 1 plus m1 into m2. This is the formula. So again, to get this, to get the angle between these two lines, we need the slope of the lines. So now just check these two lines. Already in the left hand side we have y only. So whatever is the coefficient of x, that will be the slope of the line. So m1 will be equal to 2 minus root 3 and m2 will be equal to 2 plus root 3. It is given in the question. Now we can substitute the value. Tan theta is equal to modulus of m1. So it will be equal to 2 minus root 3. Minus sign is there and two terms are there. So minus will get multiplied inside. Then we will get minus 2 minus root 3 by 1 plus m1 into m2 means 2 minus root 3 into 2 plus root 3. Now we'll simplify it. Tan theta is equal to modulus of here 2 and minus 2 will get cancelled. Minus root 3 minus root 3 will be equal to minus 2 root 3 by here 1 plus. Here we can use the identity. It is in the form of a minus b into a plus b. So that will be equal to a square minus b square. What will be 2 square? 4 minus root 3 square 3. So 4 minus 3, 1. So we are getting tan theta is equal to modulus of minus 2 root 3 by 2. Both will get cancelled. So we are getting here tan theta is equal to, since it is modulus, it will be positive, but you have to take both the condition there. So at present it will come tan theta is equal to root 3. So if tan theta is equal to root 3, what will be the value of theta? Theta is equal to 60 degree, because tan gives root 3 when the angle is 60 degree. Or what can be one more angle there? Because when we are calculating angle between two lines, angle can be this one. So at present we got this angle is equal to 60 degree. And this is also angle between these two lines only. So what will be that angle? Yes, it will be equal to 120 degree. So just write down there 60 degree or 120 degree. So I hope this question is clear. Okay, now we'll check the next question. In the next question also we have to find the angle only. So in that question it is written, find the angle between the lines 3x plus y plus 12 is equal to 0. And second one is x plus 2y minus 1 is equal to 0. So now here, first what we have to do, we have to convert it into slope intercept form. So x except y, rest all the expressions we will shift to another side there. So here you just check y is equal to what will come? Minus 3x minus 12. In the second one what will come? 2y is equal to minus x plus 1, or y is equal to minus 1 by 2x plus 1 by 2. So from here m1 is equal to minus 3, because coefficient of x is minus 3. And m2 is equal to, we are getting minus 1 by 2. Now we will write down here tan theta is equal to modulus of m1 minus m2 by 1 plus m1 into m2. Just to substitute the value m1, that is equal to minus 3 minus of minus 1 by 2. So minus 3 plus 1 by 2 by 1 plus m1 into m2. Minus 3 into minus 1 by 2. So that will be equal to plus 3 by 2. So just to simplify it, do the cross multiplication, then we will get here minus 6 plus 1 minus 5 by 2 divided by, here we are getting 5 by 2. So 5 by 2 and 5 by 2 will get cancelled. We will get here tan theta is equal to modulus of minus 1, or we can write tan theta is equal to 1 there. Then what will be the angle theta is equal to? Yes, theta is equal to 45 degree, or one more angle can be 180 minus 45. So we'll get there 135 degree. So it will be better if you will mention both the angles, because when we are writing in this way, we have to take tan theta is equal to 1, and since modulus is there, it can be plus 1, it can be minus 1 also. Okay. Now, next question. In question number 6, it is written, the line through the point A, 2A and minus 2, 3. It is given the line through the point A, 2A and minus 2, 3. Minus 2, 3. Intersect the line. This line is intersecting another line 4x plus 3y. 4x plus 3y plus 5 is equal to 0 at right angle. So the line is intersecting another line at right angle. We have to find the value of A there. Okay. So information is given. Suppose this is the line L1 and L2. So it is given L2 is perpendicular to L1 because it is intersecting at right angle there. So if it is perpendicular to L1, what we can say? Yes, if two lines are perpendicular to each other, product of their slopes will be equal to minus 1. So first we can calculate the slopes of these two lines. So L1, slope of L1 we can take as M1 and slope of L2 we can take as M2. How we will calculate the slope of L2? Yes, M2 is equal to. How we will calculate? Yes, our old formula. Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. So it will be equal to 3 minus 2A by minus 2 minus A. 3 minus 2A by minus 2 minus A. That is the slope of M2. Now slope of M1, how we will calculate? Yes, by converting it into slope intercept form. So 3Y is equal to minus 4X minus 5. Or Y will be equal to minus 4 by 3X minus 5 by 3. So from here we will get M1 is equal to minus 4 by 3. And we know if two lines are perpendicular to each other, product of their slopes will be equal to minus 1. So either you can use the concept M1 into M2 is equal to minus 1, or you can use one more concept. Since it is perpendicular, what will be the slope of L2? Take the reciprocal and change the sign. So slope of M2 will be equal to 3 by 4. Whatever, which method is easy for you, you can use there. So at present, I am just substituting the value. M1 is equal to minus 4 by 3 and M2 is equal to 3 minus 2A by minus 2 minus A is equal to minus 1. So this minus 4 by 3 we can shift to right hand side. Then it will come 3 into minus 1 by minus 4. So minus and minus will get cancelled. Remaining it will be equal to 3 minus 2a by minus 2 minus a is equal to 3 by 4. Now we can simplify it by cross multiplication. So 4 3s are 12 minus 4 2s are 8a is equal to 3 into minus 2 minus 6. 3 into minus a will be equal to minus 3a. So minus 3a we can shift here. Then we will get minus 8a plus 3a. So minus 5a is equal to minus 6 minus 12. Minus 6 minus 12 will be equal to minus 18. And we will get here a is equal to minus 18 by minus 5, or A is equal to 18 by 5. Okay. Now, next question. In question number 7, it is written. Prove that the line through the point x1, y1. So, a line is there which passes through the point x1, y1 and parallel to the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is a into x minus x1 plus b into y minus y1 is equal to 0. So we have to find, we have to prove the equation of this line. So we are finding the equation of this line L. Here you can take this line as L1, slope as M1, and here we can take the slope as M there. So since the two lines are parallel to each other, product their slopes will be equal. So first we can check what will be the slope of this line. Convert it into standard form. Then we will get by is equal to minus ax minus c, or y is equal to minus a by bx minus c by b. So what is the slope of line L1? M1 is equal to minus a by b. Now just write down there, since L is parallel to L1, therefore what we can say, M also will be equal to minus A by B. Now we will find out the equation of L. So just write down their equation of L according to the formula Y minus Y1. We have the point Y1 only. Y minus Y1 is equal to minus A by B into X minus X1. Now we can shift here and we can rearrange as given in the question. So b into y minus y1 only we want. So we can shift here. Then we will get b into y minus y1 is equal to minus a into x minus x1. Now just to check how we need the proof. Yes, right hand side should be equal to 0. So minus a into x minus x1 also you can shift to left hand side. So minus will become plus and just rearrange it. So a into x minus x1 plus b into y minus y1 is equal to 0. This is only we have to prove. So I hope this question is clear. Okay, now we'll check what is the next question. In the next question it is written, find the equation of the right bisector of the line joining. Okay, so question number 8, it is written, find the equation of the right bisector of the line joining 1 comma 3 and 3 comma 1. Equation of right bisector meaning what? Perpendicular bisector. So it is perpendicular also and it is bisecting also, correct? So here suppose if you want you can give some point there, A, B, and here we can see and D there. So D is the CD is perpendicular bisector of AB. Slope of AB we can take as M1 and slope of CD we can take as M. Since it is perpendicular and it bisects also, then what will be the coordinate of D? Yes, D is the midpoint of AB. So coordinate of D we can calculate using the formula of midpoint there. So it will be equal to x1 plus x2 divided by 2. Then we will get 1 plus 3, 4 divided by 2 will be equal to 2. 3 plus 1 divided by 2. So that also will be equal to 2 only. So we got the point on the this line CD there. Now we want the slope also. So first what we can do, we can calculate the slope of AB. Slope of AB taken as M1 is equal to, what will come according to the formula? Y2 minus Y1. So 1 minus 3 minus 2 by X2 minus X1. 3 minus 1, 2. Change it. Then we will get M1 is equal to minus 1. Now just write down there. AB is perpendicular to CD. Therefore, what will be the slope of CD? Take the reciprocal and change the sign. So 1 by minus 1. So you will get the slope is equal to 1. Now we will write down there. Equation of CD that will be equal to y minus y1. In place of y1 what we have? 2 is equal to 1 into x minus x1. Now just to simplify it, we'll get y minus 2 is equal to x minus 2. Rest all we can shift to right hand side. Then we will get x minus y minus 2 plus 2. So that will be equal to 0. So our equation will come x minus y is equal to 0. Okay. Now next question is, find the coordinate of foot of the perpendicular. Find the coordinate of foot of the perpendicular drawn from the point 1 comma minus 2. Drawn from the point 1 comma minus 2 on the line y is equal to 2x plus 1. On the line y is equal to 2x plus 1. Now just check the question there. What is given? Find the coordinate of foot of the perpendicular. Foot means the same there. Foot of the perpendicular. So if I am standing here, this will be my foot there. So I want the coordinate of this point. Okay. So I want the coordinate of foot of the perpendicular. This line is perpendicular to the given line. So suppose this is L1 and this is L. So we want the coordinate of this point there. So how to get the coordinate of that point? So you can check here when if two lines they are intersecting at this point. Suppose equation of this line is given. X minus y is equal to 3 and x plus y is equal to 5. So when we are solving these two equations, what we are getting? We are getting the common solution of these two equations, means we are getting the coordinate of the intersection point. So here also coordinate of foot of the perpendicular. So this point is on this line also and is on the line L also. So equation of L1 is already given. Now what we are going to do? we'll find out the equation of L. And after that, we will solve both the equation. Coordinate of x and y will be the coordinate of foot of the perpendicular. Clear? Okay. So already the slope L1 is written in the form of y is equal to mx plus c. So slope of L1 taking as m1, slope of L taking as m there. So can you tell me what is m1? Yes, m1 is equal to 2. And can you tell me, just write down there, L is perpendicular to L1, therefore, what will be the value of M? Take the reciprocal and change the sign. So, it will be equal to minus 1 by 2. Now, we will calculate the equation of line L there. So, equation of L, according to the formula, Y minus Y1. So, minus of minus 2, that will be equal to plus 2, is equal to M. Minus 1 by 2 into x minus x1. Shift the expression here, then we will get 2y plus 4 is equal to minus x plus 1. Now we can shift all the expression to one side, then we will get here x plus 2y plus 3 is equal to 0. So we got the equation here. Now what we need? We need the coordinate of foot of the perpendicular, means we need the intersection point of these two lines. So for that we have to simplify these two lines, and since already y is equal to 2x plus 1 is given, in place of y I am going to substitute that value. Substitution method I am using there. X plus 2 into 2x plus 1 plus 3 is equal to 0. Now we'll simplify it. We will get x plus 2 into 2, 4x plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 0. Then we will get here 5x plus 5 is equal to 0, or we can divide the whole equation by 5. Then will come x plus 1 is equal to 0, or x is equal to minus 1. So we got the value of x. Now we can substitute the value of x here to get the value of y. So 2 into minus 1 plus 1. So first we have to do the multiplication. If multiplication and addition both are there, then 2 into minus 1 minus 2 plus 1. So y coordinate is also coming is equal to minus 1. So just write down there coordinate of foot of the perpendicular is minus 1 comma minus 1. So I hope this question is clear to you. What we did here, already equation of this line is given. First we calculated the equation of this line, and to get the coordinate of foot of the perpendicular, we solved these two equation. Intersection point we got there. Okay. Now we'll check the next question. In the next question it is written, find the image of the point. Find the image of the point minus 8 comma 12 with respect to the line mirror. Find the image of the point minus 8 comma 12 with respect to the line mirror. 4x plus 7y plus 13 is equal to 0. So now you have to check how we will find out the image of any point there. Now imagine you are standing in front of the mirror there. So, what relation will come between you and your image there? So, first relation will be you and your image. They will be at equal distance from the surface of the mirror. Correct? So, if this is the mirror and this is the point there. So, if this distance is equal to 4 units, then obviously the distance of your image from the mirror also will be equal to 4 unit only. Correct? So what is the concept we got there? These two distances are same, which means this point will be the midpoint of you and your image there. What is the point on the surface of the mirror? That will be the midpoint of you and your image. So suppose this point I have taken as A and this one as B, the image of the point A I am considering as B, and since already x1, y1, everything we are using there, so to avoid the confusion I am writing it as alpha and beta there. So now first condition we got, this will be the midpoint there. Now what relation will come? So when you are standing here in front of the mirror, what will be the angle between the surface of the mirror and the line when we will draw there? Okay, so I am standing here and this is the mirror. So obviously after the mirror, at some distance my image will come. So if I will draw a straight line there from that point, from me to my image, then what relation will come? Yes, that line will be perpendicular to the surface of the mirror. So at present, this line we have to consider as a mirror. So obviously, this line will be perpendicular to the mirror. So this is the concept which we are going to use here. So as you can check, what we did in the previous one, till here we know how to, this is the foot of the perpendicular drawn from the point minus 8 comma 12. So first what we will do, we'll calculate the coordinate of this point. So for that, again we want the equation of this line. So suppose this one is L1 and this one we are taking as L, and here slope is M1 and this slope we can take as M there. So just to check, what will be the slope of L1 there, convert it in the standard form, plus 13 is equal to 0. Then from here we will get 7y is equal to minus 4x minus 13, or y is equal to minus 4 by 7x minus 13. So M1 is equal to minus 4 by 7. Now just to write down, since L is perpendicular to L1, what will be the value of M? Yes, M will be equal to 7 by 4. Take the reciprocal and change the sign. Now we will check what is the equation of L. So Y minus Y1, that is equal to 12, is equal to M 7 by 4 into X minus X1. So X minus minus 8 will be equal to X plus 8. Now 4 we can shift to left hand side. Then we will get 4Y minus 12 4s are 48 is equal to 7x plus 7 8s are 56. And now we can shift all the expression to one side. Then we will get here 7x minus 4y 56 plus 48. So that will be equal to plus 8 plus 6 40 in carry over 1. 5 plus 4 9 plus 1 10 is equal to 0. So we got the equation of this line as 7x minus 4y plus 104 is equal to 0. Now to get the coordinate of this one, what we have to do? We have to simplify these two equations. So now we are going to solve the two equations to get the coordinate of foot of the perpendicular. So elimination method we can use. So for that, what we have to do? We have to make either the coefficient of x equal or coefficient of y equal there. So can we make the coefficient of y equal? So for that, this equation you have to multiply it by 7, because here coefficient of y is 7. So it will be equal to 7 7s are 49x minus 7 4s are 28y plus 7 4s are 28 carry over 2, 7 1s are 7 is equal to 0. And this equation we are going to multiply it by 4 there. Don't check the sign there, just the number 4. Then we will get here 4 4s are 16x plus 4 7s are 28y plus 13 4s are will be equal to 52 is equal to 0. Now what we will do? We'll add the two equations. Then here 28 and minus 28y will get cancelled. 49 plus 16, so that will be equal to 9 plus 6, 15. Carry over 1, 4 plus 1, 5 plus 1, 6. So 65x plus, here it will be equal to 8 plus 2, 10. Carry over 1, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 1, 8. Carry over 1, carry over will not come. 8 plus 2, 10. Carry over 1, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 1, 8. 780 is equal to 0. So now we will get 65x is equal to minus 780, or x is equal to minus 780 by 65. Now we can cancel it, both the numbers are divisible by 13. So we can cancel it by 13. 13 5s are 65, 13 6s are 78, here minus sign, and then again we can cancel then it will be equal to minus 12. So we got here x is equal to minus 12. Now we can substitute the value of x in any one of the equation. So suppose this one is easy. Here we can substitute 4 into minus 12 plus 7y plus 13 is equal to 0. 4 into minus 12 minus 48 plus 7y plus 13 is equal to 0. Now minus 48 plus 13 will be equal to 8 minus 3, 5, 4 minus 1, 3. So minus 35 plus 7y is equal to 0. Or we will get y is equal to 7y is equal to 35, y is equal to 5. So at present we haven't got the image of the point. At present we solved the equation and we got the coordinate of foot of the perpendicular, and that is minus 12 comma 5. So we got the coordinate of foot of the perpendicular as minus 12 comma 5. And in the starting only, what is the relation there? This point is the midpoint of AB. Now we can use the concept of midpoint. How we are calculating the midpoint? X1 plus X2 divided by 2. So just write down there, minus 8 plus alpha divided by 2 is equal to, already we have the y, x coordinate, that is minus 12. Now we can simplify it, then we will get minus 8 plus alpha is equal to minus 24, or alpha is equal to minus 24 plus 8. So that will be equal to minus 16. Similarly, we'll calculate the value of beta. 12 plus beta by 2 is equal to, what is the y coordinate we have? 5. So from here we will get 12 plus beta is equal to 10, or beta is equal to minus 2. So we got the value of alpha as minus 16 and beta as minus 2. So just write down the answer there. Image of the point minus 8 comma 12 is minus 16 comma minus 2. So I hope the question is clear to you. This is quite a lengthy question, and if this question will come, this is an important question also, because concept of mirror image you have to use in class 12 also. So if this question will come, so obviously it will come for 6 mark only. Okay, so I hope whatever questions we did today, these all questions are clear to you. So all of you please note down your homework. Your homework will be exercise 10.3. Homework exercise 10.3, question number 7 to 10, and then question number 13, 14, then from miscellaneous exercise, question number 14 and 18. Okay, exercise 10.3 from question number 7 to question number 10, then question number 13, 14, and then from miscellaneous exercise, question number 14 and 18. So all the questions are based on today's class only. So do all the questions, and in case of any doubt, you can ask. Thank you.